Hydrogen, the simplest of elements. One little proton hanging around. Often, it's its own best friend, H2. It also gets along with oxygen, and that's water, and you drink it. So how in the heck can it power a car? We're talking about hydrogen fuel cells. Look, even if you think the Earth isn't very old, and petroleum-based fuels are somehow a sort of regenerative blood of the land like that guy in the comments, we know that what your car farts isn't great for the planet or its inhabitants. What if we could use a fuel, get energy out of it, and its only waste was, say, water? That's a hydrogen fuel cell powered car. First things first, a car that runs on hydrogen is an electric vehicle. You wanna learn how most of those work? Check out the video. A hydrogen fuel cell takes the energy from combining hydrogen and oxygen and creates an electric current, but it's different than the big lithium-ion batteries in the bellies of these Teslas. Hydrogen fuel cells actually complete a chemical reaction in which the hydrogen is combined with the oxygen in the environment and discarded as water. The concept of a fuel cell like this was first demonstrated by Humphrey Davy in 1801, but the invention of the first working fuel cell is credited to William Grove, a chemist, lawyer, and physicist. Grove's experiments with what he called a gas voltaic battery proved in 1842 that an electric current could be produced by an electrochemical reaction between hydrogen and oxygen over a platinum catalyst. So, how does it work? Well, first, you might be thinking, Bart, how can I trust that hydrogen and oxygen makes water and that there's a lot of energy to be had when that happens? Well, I'm glad you asked. So this is kind of the opposite of what happens in a fuel cell. We're gonna take water and split it up. Thanks to the electric current, we're separating the bonds between the hydrogen and the oxygen. And I'm trying to collect the hydrogen in this tube. The oxygen, more than likely, is just bonding with the metal of the other screw. Thanks, Felipe. That was a sincere thanks. That wasn't like a sarcastic, like you screwed something up. You didn't screw anything up. We're just gonna wait till this test tube fills. Science is a lonely game. We got about 15 milliliters. So we got a little bit more than 10 milliliters of hydrogen in here. And hydrogen is lighter than air, so it goes up. Pretty cool! Well, that's kind of what happens in a fuel cell. Two hydrogens combined with an oxygen, but it's not exactly the same. So let's get in there. It works because hydrogen, the most prolific element in the universe, is also the simplest. Here's the fuel cell in a hydrogen-powered electric vehicle. It's got a few main parts. We'll go over them, then we'll watch it in action to see how they tie together to power your car. First, let's look at the anode. The anode, the negative post of the fuel cell, has several jobs. First, it conducts the electrons. We'll see how that happens in a minute. And second, it has channels etched into it that disperses the hydrogen equally over the surface of the catalyst. Catalyst basically means something that makes another thing happen. The cathode, the positive post of the fuel cell, has channels etched in it to distribute the oxygen to the surface of the catalyst. It also conducts the electrons back from the external circuit to the catalyst, where they can recombine with the hydrogen ions and oxygen and form that sweet, sweet water of life. Water. The electrolyte is the proton exchange membrane. This specially treated material, which looks something like an ordinary kitchen plastic wrap, only conducts positively charged ions. The membrane blocks electrons. The catalyst is a special material that facilitates the reaction of oxygen and hydrogen. It's usually made of platinum nanoparticles and very thinly coated onto carbon paper or cloth. The catalyst is rough and porous, so the maximum surface area of the platinum can be exposed to the hydrogen or oxygen. The platinum-coated side of the catalyst faces the proton exchange membrane, or PEM. That's that thing that doesn't let electrons through. So now, let's get things moving. The membrane allows the protons to pass through it virtually unimpeded, while the electrons are blocked. The hydrogen hits the catalyst and splits up. A single hydrogen molecule is a proton. So the protons, hydrogens, get to pass through the membrane directly to the cathode side, while the electrons are forced to travel through an external circuit. Neither the protons nor the electrons like being charged. They want to be neutral, like the Swiss. Hey, why do the most neutral countries make the least neutral cheeses? So the electrons travel from the anode to the cathode. And this is what drives the electric motors and lights and dashboards and all the other stuff that makes driving driving. And we cover that in our electric cars video. Meanwhile, on the cathode side of the fuel cell, oxygen gas, O2, is being forced through the catalyst, where it splits into two oxygen atoms. Each of these atoms has a strong negative charge. This negative charge attracts two hydrogen ions through the membrane, where they get their electrons back and combine with an oxygen atom, making water. This circuit will keep running for as long as there's supplies of hydrogen and oxygen. And since there's plenty of oxygen in the air, the only limiting factor is how much hydrogen there is in the tank. And all it pumps out is water. No NOx, no carbon monoxide, no hydrocarbons. And another benefit is you can fill up your hydrogen tank as quickly as a gas tank, eliminating the time it takes to charge modern conventional electric vehicle. And people are like, yeah, but hydrogen's dangerous. Guys, we're using gasoline now. You're driving around with gasoline in your car. So, why aren't we using it all the time? Well, one reason is people are reluctant to get a hydrogen fuel cell EV because there's nowhere to fill it up. Some states are funding initiative, but that's a long way off. Also, we're still looking for good ways to get it. The way I got hydrogen earlier was using electrolysis. It doesn't make much sense to use electricity to get hydrogen to make electricity, does it? But we can use the sun, and there's chemists pioneering ways to efficiently unlock the most common element in the universe. That's hydrogen! Go into chemistry and save the world! Hydrogen fuel cells! Make sure you subscribe, because we got new stuff coming out almost every day of the week. Click this little button that says donut. This means you're subscribing to our channel. We got great shows. We're trying to do new stuff. If you want to see anything new, this is how we get to make it happen. You can follow us on Twitter and Instagram, at Donut Media. Follow me, at BidsBarto. Shop for your favorite donut merch at shop.donut.media. Who killed public transportation from this wheelhouse? Check out the new car show. Don't tell my wife I'm playing with hydrogen. She worries.